Parker shirts, a recent phenomenon really in football and FA Cup finals. There hardly seems to be a Newcastle fan here without one, and it's pretty much the same story in the other half of the stadium. In many ways, this has been a season when the FA Cup has had to fight for its place in the pecking order. But the epic semi-finals at Villa Park, a reminder of its compelling drama. Newcastle United to kick off. Again against the champions as they were a year ago. Again, despite the change in management, finishing 13th in the Premiership. 33 points in league terms, the gap between these two sides. Sense of purpose. Palmer.
Just looking at Roy Keane, Martin, that tackle from Gary Speed. You know, he went off with a damaged ankle. And he just got up just rather gingerly. He's limping at the moment. Roy Keane, he doesn't look happy. This is the tackle from Speed. Keane's just taking time, wandering about. You see the left ankle just buckle under him. Twisted it, there isn't a doubt in my mind of that. It's just how much damage to the ligaments is the twist.
Shearer. Solano! And Schmeichel has to hold it at the second attempt, but that's in keeping with the early mood from Newcastle United.
Lovely volley, beautiful technique from Solano, it's never beaten him.
Scholes. Xavi cuts it out, he's had a full week's training. And he looks okay, but we can't say the same about Roy Keane. His life has gone downhill since he collected the Premiership trophy last Sunday. And with just 8 minutes gone, the Manchester United captain has to go off. An ankle injury. Ryan Giggs runs across to talk to Alec Ferguson. Teddy Sheringham comes on. And that is very tough to take for a very tough character. Gary Neville with a throw. May. Put up, dangerous play, indirect free kick. Beckham rolls it to Scholes. May, trying to feed it into the feet of Andy Cole, who took it very well under some pressure. Sheringham. Scholes. For Sheringham! Brilliant play by Manchester United, and the substitute has struck. What an extraordinary set of circumstances. Here. Heads down, Roy Keane off, arms up in elation for the man who's replaced it. Absolutely super for Sheringham.
Well, the game certainly started now for Manchester United. What a move, what quality. But I'll tell you something, Andy Cole's pass here, Martin, it's to Giggs. Sheringham just sticks out a leg, but what he did from there, two exquisite touches. I thought Scholes was going to hit it, but he just faces a quite beautiful ball here. Perfectly weighted. Sheringham's only concern is hitting it and hitting the target because the ball's so good.
Scholes, Sheringham free. Able to steer it on for Solskjaer, but not with sufficient power. Manchester United playing the percentages here. Gary Neville. Solskjaer makes a move, but it's over him towards Sheringham. Beckham didn't quite sit up for the shot, so he's nudged it wide to Neville. A touch by Solskjaer at the near post. It's still in play. Giggs for Sheringham. A classy response. Solskjaer calls it. And it's hooked away from the very line itself by Dabi Szas.
They're hanging on by the fingernails in this moment in time. Pressure mounting, pressure building. Two glorious chances for Manchester United. I think this is a great opportunity. It's a wonderful ball, Beckham-like in its delivery. And look at Solskjaer at the near post. I think he's on the way down when he meets the header, because he should be hitting the target. And this, whether he's offside, it's very much touch and go, but he mishits it totally.
Backing up Lee as the ball breaks loose. Shearer, he's got support from Ketsbier. Domi. Ketsbier. Bahama. He does pack a punch with that right foot, like that. And Peter Schmeichel turns it aside.
What a save, what a strike. That's the threat of Pete Bahama. I don't think Philip Neville closes him down quick enough as he skips past goals here. He doesn't really get to it, Philip Neville. That's a very good save from Peter Schmeichel. They're just growing a little bit in confidence. You get the feeling, Newcastle.
Well, he didn't get the ball in straight away from the corner. Now it comes in from Rob Lee. And some half-hearted appeals by the Newcastle players for a penalty. Dabi Szas had stayed forward.
I'll tell you what, if Dabi Szas had gone round the other side, Ronny Johnson, it might have been interesting, because Ronny Johnson waits for this. He doesn't look, he doesn't go and attack it. Dabi Szas just went in wrong side.
Here goes Sheringham again. Gary Neville's cross, and Newcastle are playing a dangerous game in their own penalty area.
Well, they are, but they can stop this. They can't stop it, Mark. The football again was beautiful. They spread it wide, they suck players in centrally and spread it wide to Gary Neville. And they haven't missed David Beckham, have they? Neville's produced two or three beautiful balls in from the right-hand side. Sheringham, another free header.
Xavi. Forward by speed. Maze header, Solano on the scene quickly. Harman for Alberto Solano. He looks for Ketsbier. He wasn't even looking for the penalty, he just stumbled. Peter Jones blows for half-time. Well, an extraordinary opening 10 minutes. Manchester United seemed in some disarray. Alec Ferguson saw Newcastle start quickly, and in one of those early jarring tackles, Roy Keane, a major casualty, caught by Gary Speed, unable to play on. Sent on Teddy Sheringham to sensational effect. This was the incident that left Keane lame again. And Paul Scholes played a huge part in Manchester United cutting through. Question marks about Newcastle's defending coming into this final. And an early Manchester United goal for them to celebrate. But that's the only goal, despite other chances. And we reach the break at Wembley. Manchester United 1, Newcastle United 0. Well, Newcastle play their big card. Whether it'll be a trump card, we wait to see. The big Scot, Duncan Ferguson, is coming on for the second half in place of Didi Hamann, who's got a hip injury. That will necessitate a change in another part of the team. But Duncan Ferguson has hurt Manchester United in the past. Six appearances against them, four goals, including coming on here to help Everton win the cup at Manchester United's expense 4 years ago. How fit he is, well, you will judge for yourselves. He is going into hospital on Monday for another groin operation. I would suggest it's how fit he believes he is that holds the key to whether Ferguson can help Newcastle turn it round with the second half underway.
Well, all Newcastle fans hope he's fit enough, Martin, to rise to a cross and nod it in past Peter Schmeichel. That would be fitness enough. I certainly think he's fit enough to do that.
Well, a year ago it was a second Arsenal goal by Nicolas Anelka that really killed them off. Manchester United looking for that position. But it was a strange first half in many ways. Now with the teams attacking the ends where their supporters are massed, an increase in the volume. And Duncan Ferguson guides it down, Salano coming in. That's the problem that Manchester United have got, and he might reach this. He's not going to pull out of a challenge with Schmeichel either.
Well, he's given a free kick, the referee, on the edge of the box. I'm not so sure it was. But the earlier header's the one. This is what I mean, they allow him to win that one. And what they're trying to concentrate on, they're saying, OK, you're not going to score from there, Duncan. And here's where he gives a free kick against them. I'm not so sure it was.
Domi. Straight ball for Duncan Ferguson, but he's won it. Shearer almost back to Ferguson again.
Brilliant defending. Ronnie Johnson took a gamble, Martin. He chanced his arm, but Shearer was going to repay Ferguson and play him in. But that was an opening.
Poor ball by Davy Zass. And Ryan Giggs on the sprint. Solskjaer and Sheringham can tee up. Paul scores! 2-0!
Wrap it up for me. Wrap it up. Unbelievable. Been on the back foot for the majority of the second half. Ryan Giggs chases a hopeful pass. This is not great defending. Knocking a ball back in there. Put it in Rose Edson. Keep it safe. But he keeps a ball in. Doesn't deal with it. And what a lovely little touch from Teddy Sheringham. So aware of Scholes backing him up. And this young lad with an eye for goal loves this place so much. Fresh from a hat-trick for England. He's now added an FA Cup final goal to his tally. Well, every picture tells a story. Take. It's Alan Shearer who goes in and causes the problems, but is it the post? Is it both? It's the post.
You don't get to the brink of a domestic double, you're taking things for granted, and still got a reasonable touch.
Are you sure? That was his left peg. He never had a reasonable touch with that when he played.
Only with his elbows, they tell me. That's a corner. It's very much uphill for Newcastle. Johnson making his run from the edge of the area. Scholes lurking with some intent. Giggs. Well, it's a great cross, maybe a millimetre or so too high for Dwight York to convert.
Absolutely right, that's all it was. Wonderful cross from Ryan Giggs. Andy Griffin trying to do his best, he can't stop him getting a half yard. Again, the marking is absolutely shocking. middle of the 6-yard box. That should be better than that. And they're right, a foot lower, and it is 3-0.
York can use Gary Neville. Scholes. For York, Scholes wants it back, gets it back. Can he get another one here? Well, it was a deflection because Harper was going the other way and was relieved to see the ball roll wide of his left-hand post.
That would have been one of Wembley's great goals. The amount of passes and the movement that went into this, but once again, no one tracks the runner. He just got caught under his feet a little. Paul Scholes at the vital moment.
Another Beckham corner. Giggs! Goodness me!
Is that his right foot? He looks a little surprised.
Well, he vowed he would never take his shirt off in a celebration like he did in the semi-final.
Well, he might have done if this had gone in. That would have been one for the scrapbook. Difficult volley, watched it beautifully. Hit it beautifully. I said, you watch goalkeepers, you know how worried they are. Steve Harper scrambling across his goal.
Lee. Sheringham just teasing it forward. Dwight York is away, mistake by Dabizas. Giggs. Here's Solskjaer. Oh, and Harper's lost it. And now can get it right on the line. Fighting each other almost for the right to make it 3-0 Manchester United.
Well, I think this should be dropped off to Scholes again. But again, they're just, I mean, who wants it? They're almost saying that. Look at Giggs, Solskjaer. They just drop it off edge of the box. Scholes right on the edge. Shot was poorly struck.
Rich, his first touch, and now speed. Domi. Speed. Helping it through. Ferguson to Ketsbier.
And it only takes a second. You can dominate and dominate matches. It only takes a second for someone at the edge of the box just to thrash at one and end up in the top corner.
Another swallow there by Red Hullet. And a defeat to swallow. I thought that might have been a free kick to Manchester United. Peter Jones decided otherwise. 8 minutes left for Newcastle. And Duncan Ferguson. Get this one down. Maric with him. Oh, and Maric is in! And he's put it wide.
Well, you can't miss chances like that in an FA Cup final when you're 2-0 down and expect to come back. Absolutely gilt-edged. He did very well just to knock it through. And it breaks him here, just edges it through. And then once in, he really, really must be hitting the target. Composed, but he's well wide.
I'm happy for the final whistle to go a bit early today. Maric for Griffin. Prepared to take on Philip Neville. And fire it across and...
That's a save, Martin. That's a save.
Crushed the fingers of Peter Schmeichel. He was thinking the referee had blown the final whistle.
He goes across, and there's the fingers yet again. The big goalkeeper.
It's back in by Ferguson, but the big goalkeeper is there again. His last game for Manchester United in England. United at the FA Cup to the Premiership. FA Cup number 4 for Alec Ferguson. That's a record, and United's class of 99 are a class apart. The domestic double. for a third time in six seasons. Two down, one to go in this glorious attempt at this unprecedented treble. Great individuals. A terrific team, whatever team the manager chooses to put out. And the backup emphasised today when the man of the match is a substitute, Teddy Sheringham.
Alex, the first club to win the double three times. What does that mean to you?
Oh, it's fantastic for the club. The players are marvellous players. Brilliant. I think we got a break of the goal, in the sense that we're trying to reorganise. I wasn't sure what to do, whether to bring on Jesper or to go for it. I just felt that with Teddy come on, I've got three front players who can score a goal. And of course, goals he can score also. I went for it that way, and Teddy was magnificent.
Well, Teddy, congratulations. It wasn't quite your first touch, that goal, but you hadn't been on long, had you?
No, it's all right. It's amazing the way this game changes about. 1 minute you're up, 1 minute you're down, and you never know what's going to happen next in football.
When you weren't chosen initially, what was your thoughts?
Oh, devastated. Devastated. I'm 33 now. You don't think you're going to get another chance and you want to play. It would have been harsh on the other lads to be left out after playing so well this season, but, you know, I mean, it's a manager's decision, and he's chopped and changed the last few games, and you just live in hope that you're going to get the nod.
It's a really well-taken goal as well, isn't it? One that you'll always be able to treasure.
Yeah, it's a nice goal. It's a little deflection, but I'm still claiming that. Don't worry about that.
Well, let's spell it out for you again, these unique achievements. Alec Ferguson's fourth FA Cup win as manager, an all-time record. The first club to win the FA Cup 10 times. The first club to do the double 3 times. Roy Keane played only a minor part today, but he limps up to collect the FA Cup, making history today in so many ways. Manchester United. Party will go on for as long as Alec Ferguson allows, and I'm sure it'll be maybe a more controlled celebration than they had earlier in the week after winning the Premiership. Adding to the Premiership, the AXA-sponsored FA Cup.